Hello everyone. So in today's session, we are going to discuss about application of determinant and matrices. So already we know that the main purpose of determinant is to solve the system of linear equation. To solve the system of linear equation, first we have to check the consistency of the system. So next we consider what is consistent system. So consistent system means a system of equation which is said to be consistent if its solution exists. So if whether the system has solution, then the system is said to be consistent system. The solution may be one or more. That may be unique solution or more than one solution. It has more than one solution also, then the system is considered as consistent system. Next, inconsistent system. So a system of equation is said to be inconsistent system if its solution does not exist. Whether the system has no solution, then the system of equation is said to be inconsistent system. So next, consider solution of system of linear equation using inverse of the matrix. So using the inverse of matrix, we have to find the solution of system of linear equation. For that, let us take one system of linear equation with three variables. So let a1x, b1y plus c1z equal to d1, a2x plus b2y plus c2z equal to d2, a3x plus b3y plus c3z equal to d3. So this is the system of linear equation with three variables, that is x, y, z. So here let us take the coefficient elements as the matrix A. Coefficients of the variables as matrix A. So the coefficients are a1, b1, c1, a2, b2, c2, a3, b3, c. And next consider unknowns as the matrix X. So here the unknowns are X, Y, Z. And matrix B as D1, D2, D3. So now this system of equation can be represented in the matrix form like this. Ax equal to b. So system of equation can be represented in the matrix form like this. Ax equal to b. So here we have two cases. So that is, consider the case 1. So in case 1, we take matrix A as non-singular. If A is non-singular matrix. Only we know that if the matrix is non-singular, then that matrix has inverse, or inverse of the matrix exists. So here also inverse of matrix exists. Already we have taken the matrix form of equation as Ax equal to b. So that is matrix A is A1, B1, C1, A2, B2, C2, A3, B3, C. And matrix X as X, Y, Z. And matrix B as B1, B2, D. So here, take this equation. Ax equal to B. For this equation, we have to pre-multiply by A inverse. By pre-multiplying A inverse, we have... So, A inverse of AX is equal to A inverse B. So, By using associative property, this can be written as A inverse A of X is equal to A inverse B. Already we know that A inverse A or A inverse is equal to I. So that is any matrix multiplied with its inverse, then we get identity matrix. So A inverse A is written as I into X is equal to B, A inverse into B. And again we know that any matrix multiplied with identity matrix, then we get the same matrix. So that X is equal to A inverse. So here X is the unique solution of system of linear equation. So the procedure we use or the method we use to solve the system of linear equation is known as matrix method. The method used to solve the system of linear equation is known as matrix method, and the formula we use to find the solution of the system of equation is X equal to A inverse. Next, consider case 2. So in case 2, we consider a matrix as matrix A as singular. So in first case, we have considered matrix as non-singular. In case 2, we are considering matrix A as singular. So if the matrix is singular, then we calculate adjoint A into So, if the matrix A is singular, then we calculate adjoint A into B. If adjoint A into B is not equal to 0, then the system is inconsistent. If adjoint of A into B is not equal to 0, then the system is inconsistent. So if the system is inconsistent, means solution does not exist. Next, if adjoint A into B is equal to 0, then system may be consistent or inconsistent according with the whether it has infinitely many solutions or no solution. If adjoint A into B is equal to 0, that may be consistent or inconsistent. That depends upon whether the system has no solution or infinitely many solutions. So now let us consider one problem. So the problem can be asked like this. Solve the equation, system of equation using matrix method. Here the system of equation is 2x plus 5y equal to 1 and 3x plus 2y equal to 7. So this is a system of linear equation with two unknowns. So now we can take matrix A as coefficient terms. That is 2, 5, 3, 2. And the unknown matrix X can be taken as X, Y, and matrix B is equal to 1, 7. So this is the matrix form of the equation. Next, first we have to check whether the matrix is non-singular or singular. So here this is the matrix A. First we have to find the determinant of the matrix. If determinant of the matrix is equal to 0, then the matrix is singular. If it is not equal to 0, then the matrix is non-singular. So here 2 to the 4 minus 3 5 the 15. So 4 minus 15 is minus 11, so which is not equal to 0. So that means matrix A is non-singular. So next we can continue. And we already know the formula that X equal to A inverse B. this we need the term A inverse. Already we have the matrix B, and again we need the inverse of the matrix. So A inverse formula is 1 by determinant A into adjoint A into matrix B. Already we have the determinant value of the matrix A, so that x is equal to 1 by minus 11 into, and we know for 2 cross 2 matrix adjoint is given by interchanging these two elements, that is 2 2, and by changing the sign of these two elements, minus 3 minus 5, and then consider the matrix B. Matrix B is 1 7. So next we have to multiply these two matrix. So 1 by minus 11. So consider first row, first column. 2 into 1, 2, minus 5 into 7, minus 35. Next, second row, first column. Minus 3 into 1, minus 3, 2 sevens are 14. So here we get column matrix. 1 by minus 11 into 2 minus 35, minus 33, minus 3 plus 14, 11. So next, outside term is 1 by minus 11. So divide each term by minus 11. So dividing this term by minus 11, we get minus minus get cancelled. 11 ones are 11 threes are. So next, here also 11 11 get cancelled. So that value is equal to minus 1. So we have taken the matrix x as x, y. So comparing those two, we can take x value as 3 and y value as minus 1. So this is the solution of given system of linear equation. Next, consider the second problem. So here the system of equation is having three unknowns. This is the system of equation with three unknowns. So let matrix A is taken as 3, minus 2, 3, 2, 1, minus 1, 4, minus 3, 2. And matrix X as X, Y, Z. And matrix B as 8, 1, 4. First, we have to check consistency of the system. That is by finding determinant of the matrix. So, determinant of A is equal to x prime column the first row. Here, the first element is 3. So, 3 is the first row, first column. Tilting first row and first column. Remaining 4 elements are there. So, take the determinant value 1 into 2, 2 minus. Minus 3 into minus 1 plus 3. Next, middle sign is minus, and already here minus 2 is there. Minus of minus 2 plus 2. Next, 2 is in second row, sorry, first row and second column. Delete the first row and second column and take the determinant of remaining 4 elements. So 2 2's are 4 minus 4 into minus 1 minus 4. Minus of minus 4 plus 2. Next, third element is 3. 3 is in first row, third column. Delete the first row and third column. So take the determinant of remaining 4 elements. 2 into minus 3, minus 6, minus 4 into 1, minus 4. So here, 2 minus 3, minus 1. So 3 into minus 1. Plus 2 into 4 plus 4, 8. Plus 3 into minus 6 minus 4, minus 10. So 3 into minus 1, minus 3. 8 to the 16. 3 into minus 10, minus. By simplifying this, we get minus 17. So 1 plus 1. First element is in first row and first column. Deleting its first row and first column, remaining 4 elements determinant is the minor of the first element. So by simplifying this, we get A11 as minus 1. Similarly, take A12. Further, multiply minus 1 power. I value is 1, J value is 2. And second element is in first row and second column. Deleting first row and second column, remaining determinant of 4 element is the corresponding minor. And simplifying this, we get A12 as minus 8. Next, for third element, corresponding cofactor is A13. So minus 1 power, I value is 1 plus J value is 3. And third element is in first row, third column. Delete the first row and third column and take the determinant of remaining 4 elements. So by simplifying this, we get minus 10. Similarly, consider the second. For second row, first element is in second row, first column. Deleting second row and first column, we get these 4 elements. And again, by simplifying this, we get the value as minus 1. Next, consider the second element. So, second element in the second row. So, that is in second row, second column. Deleting second row and second column, remaining elements are 3, 3, 4, 2. And by taking determinant of those 4 elements, we get A22 value as minus 6. And for third element, we multiply minus 1 power, I value is 2, J value is 3. And third element is in second row and third column. Deleting second row and third column, we get 3 minus 2, 4 minus 3. Again, by simplifying this, we get the value as 1. So next, consider the third row, and using the same procedure, we get the cofactors as minus 1, 9, 7. And we know that A inverse is given by 1 by determinant of A into adjoint of A. Adjoint of A is transpose of cofactor matrix. So directly I have taken the transpose of cofactors, that is first row cofactors comes to the first column. So this is the adjoint of the matrix A. So next we have to find the x, y, that is we have to find unknown star x, y, z. For that we use the formula x equal to A inverse. So here A inverse value is 1 by minus 17 into minus 1, minus 5, minus 1, minus 8, minus 6, 9, minus 10, 1, 7. And which is again multiplied with the matrix. Matrix B is 8, 1, 4. So 1 by minus 17 into. So first row, first column, first element. Minus 1 into 8, minus 8, minus 5 into 1, minus 5, and 4 into minus 1, minus 4. Next, second row, first column. Minus 8 into 8, minus 64. Next, minus 6 into 1, minus 6. Next, 9 fours are 36. Plus 36. Next, consider third row. So, by the multiplying third row elements with first column, minus 10 into 8, minus 80. Next, 1 into 1, 1, plus 1, 7 fours are 28. So here, by simplifying that, we get x equal to 1 by minus 17 into. So by simplifying this, we get the values as minus 17, minus 34, minus 51. Now divide each term by minus 17. By dividing and then we have to find the solution by using matrix method. Here the problem is like this: the sum of three numbers is 6, and if we multiply third number by 3 and add second number to it, we get 11. By adding first and third number, we get double of second number. Represent it algebraically and find the numbers using matrix method. Here we have three numbers and we don't know the numbers. So let us take the numbers as x, y, z. So let us take three numbers as x, y, z. And here look at the first statement. The sum of three numbers is 6. So that is sum of, that is first equation. Sum of these three numbers is 6. So x plus y plus z is equal to 6. And next statement is, if we multiply third number by 3, third number is z. So we have to multiply the number by 3 and add second number to it. So for that element, we have to add second number, that is y. And by adding those two, we get the sum as 11. So first we have to multiply third number by 3. So that is 3z, and add second number to it, that is y. Then we get the value as 11. So this is second equation. So here we don't use the first term. Next, third sentence is, by adding first and third number. First and third numbers are x and z. By adding first and third number, we get double of second number. So here second number is y. Double of second number means 2y. So by taking 2y to this side, we can take the value as x minus 2y plus z equal to 0. So here we get the system of linear equation. So that for this matrix, for this system, matrix A is 1, 1, 1. Here we don't have the x value, so that can be taken as 0 into x. So the coefficient is 0, 1, 3. And for last equation, 1 minus 2, 1. And x, unknowns are x, y, z. And matrix B is 6, 11, 0. Next, we have to find the determinant of the matrix. That is, determinant of A is equal to, expanding along the first row, we get 1 into 1 is the first row and first column. Delete the first row and first column. 1 into 1, 1. Minus, minus 2 into 3, minus 6. Minus of minus 6, plus 6. Next, middle sign is minus and second element is 1. And second element is in second column, first row. Delete the second column and first row. Remaining elements are 0, 3, 1, 1. So 0 into 1, 0. Minus 1 into 3, 3. Plus third element is 1. 1 is in third row, third first row, third column. So next 0 into minus 2, 0. Minus 1 into 1, 1. So by simplifying this, we get determinant value as 9. So which is not equal to 0. So the matrix is non-singular. Next, we find the adjoint of the matrix. Again, we have to find the cofactors of all the elements. So for first row, cofactor is A11. For first element, cofactor is A11. So that is minus 1 power I value is 1 and J value is 1. And corresponding minor is like this. So by simplifying this, we get cofactor of first element as 7. And for second element, and second element is in first row, second column. Deleting first row and second column, corresponding minor is like this. So again, by simplifying this, we get cofactor as 3. And for third element, is the first row and third column. Deleting its first row and third column, we get minor as 0, 1, 1 minus 2. Again, by simplifying this, we get A13 value as minus 1. Next, consider the second row. So, in second row, first element is in second row, first column. So, deleting its first row and second row and first column, we get the minor as 1, 1, minus 2, 1. So, again, by simplifying this, we get the value as minus 3. Similarly, we can find cofactors of remaining elements. So, next, by taking transpose of the cofactor, we get adjoint of the matrix as 7, minus 3, 2, 3, 0, minus 3, minus 1, 3, 1. So, using this adjoint, we have to find the solution. So, x equal to A inverse D. So, A inverse is given by 1 by determinant of A into adjoint of A into matrix B. So, here determinant value is 9 and adjoint of the matrix is 7, minus 3, 2, 3, 0, minus 3, minus 1, 3, 1. And matrix B is 6, 11, 0. So now we have to multiply these two matrices. First row, first column. 7 6 are 42, minus 3 into 11, minus 33, plus 2 into 0, 0. Next, second row, first column. 3 6 are 18, 0 into 11, 0, minus 3 into 0, 0. Next, third row, first column. Minus 1 into 6, minus 6, 3 into 11, 33, plus 1 into 0, 0. So, by simplifying this, we get 1 by 9 into 42 minus 33, 9, 18. So, minus 6 plus 33 is 27. Now, divide each element by the 9. So, by dividing these 3 elements by 9, we get the values as 1, 2, 3. So, that is x equal to 1, y equal to 2, and z equal to 3. So, this is the solution.